Hey, and welcome back to the channel. My name is Alexander, and I'm a guitarist, composer, and overall music nerd from Copenhagen, Denmark. And in this video, we're checking out the cool new singles library from New Vintage Audio. So, first of all, before anything else, sorry about wearing a hat indoors, but it's starting to get pretty damn cold here in Denmark, so I need to keep the heat up. As some of you may know, I collaborate with Dan, who is the owner of New Vintage Audio, and I work there as a creator doing different Helix patches. There's also a bunch of other cool creators working there who does X-Effect fractal stuff, MOA preamp stuff, and we're even working on some impulse response goodies for you guys. So recently, Dan got in touch with me about doing a video about his new product, the Singles Library, and that is why we're here today. So the big idea behind the concept is that it is, of course, a library of different presets for effects in different categories, so it makes it super easy for you to come up with just that specific tone that you need. This means that you can save a lot of time because you can get brilliant results really, really quickly. Also, you don't need to spend hours and hours on end really diving into what does all of these different effect pedals do and how do I achieve this specific sound, because Dan has simply done it for you. If you're interested in composition, lessons, music production and tutorials, make sure to subscribe to the channel and ring the bell so you don't miss my weekly videos. All relevant links are in the description. It's all free, so you have no excuse. Do it. Do it for glory. It can be a little difficult trying to sort of grasp this whole library thing, just explaining it with words. So let's just dive right into the screencast and I'll kind of show you and build a few different tones using this library so you can see exactly how easy it is. Okay, welcome back to Helix Edit. First of all, I'm gonna go through the entire structure of this whole singles library so you can see how the system sort of works and how it's meant to be used. You can of course use it however you want once you get your hands on this. And then I'm gonna dive into building a few quick patches. I'm gonna build a clean patch and a dirty patch. I don't know yet if it's gonna be a rhythm or a lead patch, but basically just a practical section so you can see how I would go about using these things and how easy it is to get great results really out of the gate without changing anything. And then you can of course start to tweak after that if you're into this. And I must say, first of all, that I'm super impressed with what Dan have done with this singles library. It's way bigger than anticipated when he reached out to me to talk about this. And yeah, there's a lot of work behind this, both with the amount of, as you can see out here, with the amount of different banks, but inside of those banks, all the tones are really dialed in and all the snapshots are really dialed in to get those specific tones that you're looking for. So this is definitely a great product if you are new to the Line 6 Helix or you have troubles dialing into these specific sounds and making them sound good, or you are simply too lazy or don't have the time to play around with all this stuff. This is a great product for that. Okay, so as I said, let's go over the structure. As you can see out in the menu here, this is what it looks like when you import the setlist file. You purchase the thing on the website and you get a file and you open it as a setlist, and this is what you get, right? Without these two that I just made to build upon it, because it would be a little easier, right? So you can see we have all sorts of different things, right? And they are categorized into these very clear categories. Ambient delays, right? We have auto swells, choruses, compressors, delays, drives, dual delays, equalizers, filters, fuzzes, long reverbs, master compressors, master EQs, master effects, and so on and so on, parallel, this and that. And the more sort of niche pitch and synth patches, we have that as well. Phasers, ring modulators, short reverbs as well. So we really have everything that we would need in order to get somewhere at least, right? And some of these may be the exact thing that you're looking for, or some of them may get you in the ballpark, and then it's way easier to tweak that little specific setting that just tips it over the edge for you, right? And as we can see, if we dive into, for example, the very first one, the ambient delay A, you'll get this. It's basically just a preset, right? And now we are on the first snapshot called Terrains. And it just has a delay after it, right? And this signifies where in the chain, the signal chain, the effect is supposed to go, right? So if this effect was moved in front of the amp, it was intended to go in front of the amp. So when you copy it into your own preset, it should of course, if you're looking for this exact effect, it should be placed correspondingly to the preset where you're taking it from. So it's a good idea to just have a look at, okay, is it before or after the amp? Is it in a parallel path or whatever? It can be all of those things, right? We'll get into that when we start building the tone as well. And then, of course, there is 3 snapshots for each bank. And this is where the amount of work just becomes astronomical to me, right? Because there is quite a lot of banks, right? I don't know how many there are. There are maybe 30 or something like that, right? Maybe a bit more. And each of them have 3 snapshots within them, right? So for example, yeah, this is the first one, the terrains. Oh, I dropped my pick yet again. Starting to become a thing. And if we change to the oceanic, you'll hear, and you can see as well in the preset, it changes effect, right, to the back one. And this is actually really cool, right? Sounds really good. And of course, the amp and that stuff is just there, so you can sort of check out, okay, what does this effect sound like? Some of them are, as this one, a clean amp, and some of them are a dirty amp, and that signifies it's supposed to, or it is at least intended to go with a sort of dirty tone or a gainy tone, right? Okay, so let's dive into creating some patches. First of all, I have set up this clean part of the patch the exact same way as the thing we just took a look at, right? So we have this, whoa. So we have just this jazz reverb with matching cab, right? Sounds like that, there's nothing special there. Okay, so how I would go about this is I usually, when going for a clean band at least, I at least put a compressor in front of it. If you watched any of my other videos, you'll know that is a thing that I like to do. So we go to the compressor section. Let's start with the A, and we have Premium Soft Studio. It's a really tired one, Studio. A bit more driven, right? Let's just go to one of the other random ones. Presence, Recording, and Redwood. Presence. Okay, out of the ones that we listen to now, I like the Premium the best. So how I would go about this is I simply take the active block, which is this snapshot, right? The first one, I right-click and I click Copy. And then I scroll all the way down to my clean preset and I saw it was before the amp. So I select the block before the amp, and then I simply paste it in, and I save my preset, and then we have this. If we take it off, yeah, quite different, right? A lot more presence and a lot clearer, and that is what compressors are meant to do. What could we do then? We could figure out maybe a chorus effect or something like that. It's not so typical me, but it can sound really good. So chorus A, subtle, analog, and dreamy. Let's go for dreamy maybe. Let's just try the other ones. Let's snatch the analog one, the middle one, and again before the amp, right, as we can see. So we copy the effect, jump all the way down to our clean preset. We put it maybe after the compressor is a good idea, like that. Now we've got this really nice chorus clean tone, right? Sounds really good and super easy. I didn't have to do anything at all other than copy blocks. I think sounded good. And then maybe let's do a reverb or delay thing. I really like the first one we actually had here. The oceanic one sounds really good to me. Very sort of post-rock and all of that kind of modern stuff. And it's the last one, as you can see, the active one. And again, simply we just copy and go down to our clean preset, and this was after the amp, and I forgot to save the chorus. I tend to do that quite a lot, it seems. Like that, and I save it. And this is, of course, after the amp, because the preset told us to, right? So now we have this. sounds really good to me. And this was super easy, right? Of course, there is this little pitfall of forgetting to save your presets. Or maybe it's just me that does that. All right, so finally for the clean tone, let's try out one of the more sort of extreme effects or niche things. And I don't do synthesizer stuff and pitch things that much on guitar. But let's check it out. I'm just going to a random one now. The pitch and synth G, it's called. So let's just check out what we got going on. It's called Swamp Thing. And I can kind of understand why this sort of growing kind of foul and full. Okay, so this is basically an octave kind of thing. Kind of like that. Okay, this is before the amp, so we copy. And as you can see here, two blocks are enabled, right? Other than the amp, of course. And there's a reverb block after the amp as well, so we had to go back and get that. So firstly, we copy this in where it's supposed to be, or paste it in, right? And then we save and go back to G, and we copy this, and we jump back here, and we paste it in, and we save again, and now. Sounds really good to me. Definitely already usable, right? If you want some kind of ambient thing with this kind of pad, synth pad sound, right? Definitely usable and super cool, and it was very easy even for me that never I don't think I ever used a pitch block in the Line 6 Helix. It worked like a charm. I picked a preset I think sounded cool, or at least suited my sort of intention, and it worked. All right, so next up is of course our dirty preset, and for this I picked the Archetype Lead, and I don't think I touched the settings at all. The cab is a dual cab setup, and it's an XXLV30 as always, and it's this 4x12 Blackback 30 that I have grown quite fond of. And sounds like this. Right, pretty basic. Okay, so again, maybe first of all, I would go for a kind of drive pedal to put in front, because we kind of like that, right? And of course, we just scroll to drives. Drive A, color, screamer. Screamer could definitely be a pick. Valve, clone, fat, secret. German S, compulsion. I'm just going through the presets and sort of looking at the names of kind of what I imagine these pedals sound like. And with these, of course, I have no idea. Trashy, lead could be something. Maybe we're going in that direction. Okay, so it has that kind of, not scooped, but kind of fattened up thing, so you don't get too high endy and stuff like that when you're soloing and playing the high notes. So let's just copy that. And as we see, it's before the amp, right? So we jump down to our dirty presets and we throw it in front of the amp. Whoop, and we save. Sounds really good, to me at least, without. Sounds a little dry and a little thin, right? So it definitely does its job. Very cool. All right, so of course, if we are now building a lead patch, as it seems, we should maybe get some delay and a bit of reverb to sort of fatten it all up. And we tried the ambient delay, so that is not what we're going for this time. So let's just check out the delay, echo chime. Could be that. Well, that sounded good. Mirrored, trans solo. New vintage background. Okay, it's a little long, dreamy. Let's go for that. I like the dreamy presets, it seems. So again, it's after the amp, right? Fairly easy. So we go back here, we throw it after the amp. Save. Already we are quite far, in my opinion at least, when it comes to getting a sort of classic rock or metal clean lead tone, right? maybe a, not a short verb, but a medium verb would be good. Classicism, Victorian and Baroque. My, oh, progressive. Yeah, modern. Still a little short. Oh, that's this octave thing. Maybe we are actually going for longer verbs. I like that. So we simply copy again, right? And we check it's after the amp. And there's also a delay thing with that. And we probably don't need it, since we already picked out one, but we could check it out. Sounds really good to me. Now I have to sort of figure out where I took it from. And it was, of course, the long verbs. Did we take this one? I think we did. And we copied this. And we hit back down. And then I think it was set up sort of like this. I don't think it really matters, but nevertheless. All right, really cool and super easy to get by, right? I got a few ideas about sort of what I wanted, and then I went to the corresponding category, and it was super easy just to try out a few different presets, or maybe just reading what the snapshots are called, and it gives you a pretty good idea about sort of what we have. A final thing we could do is, of course, if we scrap the last thing we did, so we have a bit more room. If you are HX Stomp user or something like that, limited blocks is definitely a thing. So we could maybe head to an equalizer thing and see what kind of, this is called solo parametric. Let's not listen to it at all. Let's just copy it in and see, because there are, of course, there are too much stuff for me to go through it all in this video. But as we went through in the beginning, there is a bit of everything, right? We have every kind of main effect that you could ever want in terms of equalizers and master EQs and master effects and stuff like that. If you want to sort of build your main tone and then sort of sculpt it afterwards with a master EQ or something like that, that is in here as well, and master compressors as well, right? So you really have all of the options, and you don't need to do all of the any of the work, because Dan have basically done it for you, right? Okay, so let's try and throw this in the back and see, just for fun. Okay, it's a very subtle, very, very subtle EQ, but it I actually feel it more when I play than I hear it. It really sort of clears up. It clears up some of the bit of muddy areas and pushes the sound a little bit, and that is really nice. Thank you very much for watching the video, guys. I hope that you enjoyed the walkthrough of the singles library, and maybe if it seems like it could be something for you, there's of course a link to it and a bunch of other cool stuff down in the description, so I would really appreciate it if you would check those out. As always, feel free to like the video and subscribe to the channel, and maybe share the video with a friend who would also benefit from this awesome product. That is all for this time, guys. Stay safe out there and stay warm. It's getting colder, so we don't need any more sick people in the world at this time. At least that's my humble opinion. Stay safe. Until next time, see ya.